University's 11th annual Veterans Day program. Our theme this year is "It's a Wonderful World Because of Your Service." My name is Sanoyia Williams, and I am the Director for Veterans Affairs and Disability Services. And
I am Ashley Greenwood, Miss Bulldog Veteran.
Unfortunately, Mr. Alfonso Smith, who is Mr. Bulldog Vets, will not be able to preside today due to illness. We hope that you have enjoyed the music prelude presented by Alabama A&M University's band. Since our official party is already seated, what we would like to do at this particular time is ask our official party to stand when we call their names. I will start with Miss ROTC, Miss Courtney Carter. Thank you. Dr. Andrew Hugini Jr., President, Alabama A&M University. Our keynote speaker for this afternoon is Colonel James Heyward. And we were blessed to have someone else that we added to our official party that is a veteran by the name of Mr. R.C. Adams. Okay. We will now have posting of the colors by Alabama A&M ROTC Color Guard, followed by singing of the national anthem, Mr. Frankie Smith, the Director of Intramural Sports and Recreation.
Were so gallantly
We will now have greetings by Dr. Andrew Higgini Jr., President of the Alabama Agricultural and Mechanical University, followed by the invocation by Mr. Alfonso Smith, Director of Testing Services.
Good afternoon. To our presiding officers, our speaker, Colonel Heyward, to Dr. Crosby, the Vice President for Student Affairs, Ms. Williams, Mr. Pearson, members of the Veterans Affairs and Disability Area, to each of you here today, but especially to our veterans and to all persons who have served or currently serving in the armed services of the United States of America. It is certainly my delight and pleasure on behalf of our Board of Trustees, our faculty, our staff, our alumni, and our students to bring you greetings as Alabama A&M University pauses today to recognize veterans. On this day, we acknowledge the blessings of freedom. We recognize the power and the virtue of sacrifice. And we respect those who gave and continue to give on behalf of the common good. As Thomas Jefferson aptly said, the price of freedom is eternal vigilance. Today we honor you, the brave men and women who responded to that call of vigilance. Men and women who sacrificed daily so that we may enjoy life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Men and women whose families make tremendous sacrifices while their loved ones are away defending our freedoms. And men and women who have made the ultimate sacrifice for our nation with their lives. Men and women who serve for life, liberty, and loyalty. We can never, ever thank you enough and repay you for what you have done. But this program today by Alabama A&M University is a small way of saying thank you. Thank you for your duty and thank you for your service. We want to particularly thank the facility here for allowing us to come here today to have this program on behalf of Alabama A&M University. To each of the participants, we thank you for being a part of this observance and celebration. I'm always reminded that as a country, we owe a debt of gratitude to each of you. That debt of gratitude must be repaid through being certain that those services which you so rightly deserve, that those services are provided. For us as a nation, to do anything other than that would be an affront. Veterans today, the entire Alabama Agricultural and Mechanical University family, we salute you, we honor you, and we say thank you.
God of our fathers, we thank you for this day of remembrance, this day when we honor those who have served this country at home and abroad. Those who have sacrificed much and those who have made the ultimate sacrifice to protect their families, their country, and the way of life we love. During this service, on this election day, we remember that we are a democratic society and all those who have passed the torch to us to share their love, honor, and duty with generations to come. God be with us now, as you have been in the past and will be in the future. Never let us waver in our commitment, conviction, and fervor. We pray. Amen.
Next, we will have an ROTC performance by the Persian Rifles of AAMU ROTC, followed by the recognition of guests and veterans by Ms. Courtney Carter, Ms. ROTC.
Court. Greetings. At this time, we would like to recognize the veterans of the United States military. Could you please raise your hand as we take a moment to recognize and thank you for the sacrifices you have made for your selfless service to our country. Thank you.
Next, we will have the introduction of the speaker by Mr. Carlton Wright, director of the university's band.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I have the distinct honor and pleasure of introducing our keynote speaker for today, a man who I admire very much and who has helped me to become the man and the leader that I am today. I will not bore you by reading his entire bio. I will just pull out some key points. Colonel retired James Heyward is a native of Sumter, South Carolina. He had a very distinguished military career as an officer in the United States Army, where he served proudly both overseas and here at home. His training and experiences have led him to do some outstanding works in the areas of training, logistics, resource management, counseling, and investigative work. Colonel Heyward's last military assignment was here at Alabama A&M University, where he served as professor of military science. During this time, he commissioned and trained over 250 officers. I am very proud to have been one of those officers that was commissioned under his leadership. He was such a visionary that he took advantage of all of the resources around him and created the AAMU Bulldog Brigade ROTC Band. He gave me and many others the opportunity to hone our military leadership skills while at the same time gaining valuable experience and confidence in our chosen fields of study. This is why today, when I returned 3 years ago as director of bands, we perform at all commissioning ceremonies for the ROTC cadets, becoming second lieutenants in the Army. Colonel Heyward holds a BS degree from South Carolina State University. He also holds the Master of Arts degree from Shippensburg State University. He is a member of the steward board of the St. John AME Church. Colonel Heyward is married to the former Willie Mae Thompson. They are the proud parents of one daughter and two sons. They are super proud of their grandchildren, four grandsons. Please join me in welcoming to the program, to the podium, Colonel James Heyward.
Thank you so much.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good Dr. Hugeeting, Mr. Thomas, Ms. Greenwood, Ms. Sanoyia Williams, Mr. R.C. Adams. I think he's one of our senior veterans here today. And Mr. Carlton Wright that you just heard. And to the veterans who we honor today, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of a grateful nation and under the sponsorship of Alabama A&M University, I have the privilege of honoring and reflecting on true heroes, our current military veterans, as well as those who are currently serving to protect the freedoms that many times we take for granted. When our service personnel enter the armed forces, they write a blank check to our nation, which includes time, resources, and efforts to include their lives in the service of this nation. Many of you know the history of Veterans Day, which began after World War I. The armistice was signed between Germany and the Allies in Belgium, ending the World War I. We know the significance of the 11th month, 11th day, and the 11th hour. And, of course, the exact time that the document was signed. Now, we have used this from time to time in years, and as you remember, many of our activities on the 11th begin at 11 o'clock, and it's traditional, and that's the reason why. After World War II, the Korean War, and other armed conflicts that our nation has been engaged in, it is most appropriate that we now recognize it as Veterans Day, honoring all former service personnel over generations. Early on, this day was called Armistice Day and was recognized all over the country. It became a national holiday in 1938. However, we must never forget that veterans of all wars in which this country has been involved served with dedication and courage. Some were confident in knowing why they fought, while others only knew that it was their duty. But they all understood the meaning of sacrifice. They served in many lonely places and were away from their families through many holidays, illness, and deaths of their family members. Today, we would like to pay a special tribute and a special thank you to the Vietnam veterans. We all know how our nation was divided during the time we were engaged in that war. We have come to realize that this is a wonderful world because of your service. When many of you returned home, you did not receive the welcome that was given to many veterans who served in other wars and conflicts. Some Vietnam veterans were actually discriminated against at certain times and at certain events. However, I must hasten to add that I personally did not receive discrimination or disrespect upon my return. I served in Vietnam during the Tet Offensive, and probably many of you who are present here today also served during that time. The Tet Offensive was one of the largest military campaigns of the Vietnam War, launched on January the 30th, 1968, by the Viet Cong and the North Vietnamese Army against the forces of South Vietnam, the United States, and their allies. I was stationed at Cu Chi, about 25 miles northeast of Saigon. My unit was attached to the headquarters, 25th Infantry Division. During Tet, we received 122 millimeter rockets and mortar attacks almost every night for 30 days. I can't possibly name all of the individual battles, the many hills that were taken, the many landing zones that were cleared, or the number of lives that were lost. The United States and their allies finally beat back the attackers, and many were in retreat, and we could declare success. We won the Tet Offensive. Shortly after this time, however, the war became more and more political. News reporters and correspondents began injecting their opinion instead of reporting the facts. Vietnam was often referred to as the most unpopular war of our time. But we must remember that American sons and daughters had no input in the decisions that were made around them, and for them. Some citizens blame the troop themselves. But we as fellow veterans know that no one is more against war than the men and women who have to fight in them. When we take an oath, we do not have the time or the capacity to sit back and decide if the orders are appropriate or justified. This is not our job. Our job is to carry out the orders that are given to us. We know that our lives may be sacrificed for a cause of which we may not agree or even understand at the time. At this time, though, I would like to run a short video depicting some of our service personnel in actions in Vietnam, and I trust that this may remind us of the many sacrifices that the veterans made as they carried out their mission and the orders of their leaders. Please run the video.
In the long history of mankind, there has never been a war which has demanded such complex tactics and so many sophisticated weapons as the war in Vietnam. An entirely new concept of warfare, known as heliborne or air mobile operations, has been developed by the United States Army and has been successfully employed to meet the problems posed by Southeast Asia's hostile wilderness and the enemy who hides there. In the fluid situation where actions are fought from one end of South Vietnam to the other, the air mobile concept has given birth to the Army Air Mobility Team. Seeking out the elusive hidden enemy, U.S. troops are daily confronted by nightmarish natural obstacles. Even at close range, the Viet Cong remain unseen. The full power of our army cannot be brought to bear upon the enemy through ground operations alone. As the American fighting men inch their way into the Asian wilderness, where the enemy has prepared underground fortresses and has entrenched himself for decades, the attack spirit of our troops is frustrated and progress is limited. A speedier, more effective method of getting at the Viet Cong and North Vietnamese Army forces had to be found. Traditionally, the need for ground movement by the Army is vital. Troops are still deployed on a massive scale on wheels and treads in Vietnam, and the final victory must be won on the ground. In order to move quickly over difficult ground and to put the firepower where it's needed, the Army developed the air mobile concept. How the air mobility team system works is demonstrated in a battalion-sized operation to search out and clear away known enemy forces. Advanced reconnaissance is the first step for any planned attack. In air mobility operations, this advanced scouting is usually done from the air. Light fixed-wing aircraft look for areas near suspected enemy positions, which will provide a suitable landing zone for the waves of assault troops, which will soon be coming in. The air mobile team concept is designed with the idea that the airborne soldier must ultimately fight on foot. Every effort is made to keep small units together on the same aircraft. A combat company's mortars and machine guns are divided among several aircraft, however, so that the loss of one or two helicopters would not knock out all the company's heavy weapons. In air mobile operations, such as the one now underway, the hilltops overlooking an enemy-held valley are pounded by Army artillery units to make way for the incoming waves of helicopters. Artillery fire is carefully coordinated with attacks directly upon enemy positions by tactical aircraft of the U.S. Air Force. The jets rain bombs into the valley to neutralize the enemy there. When the fighter-bomber attack is masked by the advance of the ground troops, the close support is continued by helicopter gunships. The air mobility team system provides another great advantage for the assault troops. In addition to flexible, rapid transport to meet any maneuver of the enemy, the U.S. infantrymen can be landed on key terrain, such as this high ground overlooking the valley. Known as vertical envelopment, this enables him to come in behind the enemy, whose prepared defenses are usually oriented to cover the ground below. Another advantage in landing atop high ground is that the assault forces are unable to attack downhill. This decreases fatigue and speeds up ground movement. The enemy is given little time in which to adjust his defenses to the attack. In an effort to land behind the enemy, some of the troops are required to land on terrain where natural obstacles make it far from an ideal landing zone. But the men of the air mobile team are extremely resourceful and manage to complete their landings despite the hazards. Here, for instance, some of the troops must descend into the solid mass of tall jungle in order to take up a strategic blocking position. The descent is made with the aid of a trooper ladder. The artillery forward observer plays a critical role, calling in and directing artillery fire. Another triumph of the air mobile team is its truly remarkable ability to shuttle artillery through the air. In Vietnam today, most aerial delivery of these field pieces is being accomplished by huge Chinook helicopter sling delivery. New lightweight howitzers have been developed especially for this role. Spectacular though the air mobile team's assaults are, these brilliant aerial deployments would grind to a halt on the ground if the troops were not constantly supplied and resupplied with the many articles of war needed to fight the battles. Things like jeeps and water trailers and ammunition. Keeping the swarms of helicopters airborne so long and so often is made possible only because the team gives these aircraft expert maintenance on the ground. Checkups and inspection procedures are exacting and carried out according to a rigid schedule. After every combat mission, an inspection is made for possible damage. Another contributing factor to the capability of these helicopters to return so swiftly to action is the multiple fueling techniques devised by the team's ingenious support personnel. Inflatable rubber fuel tanks, flown well forward of the main airbase, cut refueling time to the bare minimum. Probably no feat of the air mobile team is as spectacular or heartwarming to the fighting man as evacuation of the wounded by medical helicopter. The swift removal of wounded soldiers from remote battlefields and aerial delivery to modern hospital facilities has cut combat fatalities to an all-time low. It is no wonder that this life-saving capability of the Army Air Mobile Team is one of the major factors in sustaining the morale and fighting spirit of the soldier. The Army Air Mobile team has prevailed. The enemy has been defeated in this confrontation with the Americans at Bong Son. One thing is clear. The battle-tested teams of infantry and armor, infantry and artillery, and the many other combined arms teams still play their historic roles in battle. But their missions are carried out faster and more effectively as part of the Army Air Mobility Team.
Thought that this would probably give you some thoughts about when you were there in Vietnam and some of the actions that took place. For most veterans, Vietnam veterans in particular, there were no homecoming parades, a recognition of service, no thank yous or offers to help them settle back in their communities. In 2011, the United States Congress made an attempt to right the wrong done to the veterans of the Vietnam era, finally acknowledging the return of our troops. March the 30th of 2011 was declared Welcome Home Day for Vietnam veterans, marking the 30th anniversary of the withdrawal of combat and combat support elements from Vietnam. But to all veterans, both living and deceased, you gave so much to ensure that we can enjoy democracy and the freedoms we enjoy today as a nation. Today is National Election Day in the United States, and it is through your selfless acts that we enjoy this privilege. When we see almost daily images in the news about the chaos in other parts of the world, we can be grateful that we live in a democracy where we change our governments at the ballot box and not at the barrels of guns. When we stop to think about how precious this freedom is, and how blessed we are as a nation, we know that your sacrifices were not in vain. Let us fight to keep it that way. We thank you for your sacrifices and your service. May God continue to bless you and your families. It has been my good fortune to have had the privilege to speak and celebrate with you today. We ask God to continue to bless and provide you comfort. God bless the United States of America. Thank you.
Next, we will have service medley by the AAMU band performance, Marching Maroon and White Ensemble.
Thank you.
Next, we will have special presentation by Dr. Andrew Higini Jr., president of AAMU, followed by Ms. Sandra Stubbs, director of alumni affairs.
Colonel Heyward, would you please join me here at the podium? Thank you so very much, Colonel Heyward, for coming and sharing with us today, sharing again at Alabama A&M University. Thank you for the service which you provide to our nation. Thank you for the service which you provide to this great university, for the lives that you have touched and inspired. We present to you this certificate in behalf of our university as the speaker for the 11th Annual Veterans Day Program, November 8th, 2016. Thank you again.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
Please. I too, like Mr. Wright, I'm a product of your service while your tenure was at Alabama A&M. I was an undergraduate student. I think I was a sophomore at that time, and we thank you for your service. I think the theme for today's program is a wonderful world because of your service, because of the time that you spent in the military and the service that you provided while you were at A&M. We're here today to present you with a bulldog basket, letting you know that we love you and we appreciate all that you're doing now and what you've done in the past for the university and for the world at large.
Well, we thank you so much.
You're welcome.
We have a special presentation we'd like to make at this time. I had the honor 2 years ago of acknowledging this person on the occasion of his 100th birthday. And again, we have the honor of recognizing him today. This is a presidential medallion proudly presented to Robert Coleman Adams in recognition of extraordinary service to humankind and country as a proud 102-year-old veteran of the United States Army. This is for valiant and incessant advocacy of voter registration, for fervent support of civil rights movement, and for passionate support of the life-changing benefits of higher education, particularly his support to Alabama Agricultural and Mechanical University as an untiring, tenacious bulldog. Presented this 8th day of November 2016, Andrew Higini Jr., President, again, thank you so very much, Mr. Adams, for your service to this nation and your service to Alabama A&M University.
Thank you, Ms.
I would also like to present you this official coin and a specially crafted presentation box that has the seal of the university affixed there too.
Next, we will have the oath of enlistment by Lieutenant Colonel Tyra Smith, U.S. Army.
It's a special day. As many of you have done before, today these cadets will take the oath of enlistment, which signifies the beginning of their journey in our Army. All 18 of these cadets have just contracted with the Army this semester. Many of them are scholarship, and the other ones are just here for the ride. So, without further ado, I will present the oath of enlistment. Raise your right hand and repeat after me. I state your full name.
I am Quentin.
You solemnly swear or affirm.
That
I will support and defend,
the Constitution of the United States
against all enemies, foreign or domestic,
and that I will bear true
faith and allegiance the same,
and that I will obey the orders
of the President of the United States
of the President of the United States
and the orders
And the orders
of the officers appointed above me. According to the regulations.
According to the regulations.
And the Uniform Code of Military Justice.
And the Uniform Code of Military Justice.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Oh, welcome to the Army.
Next, we will have acknowledgments by Dr. Andrew Higini, president of AAMU.
Congratulations to the cadets. Thank you so very much for the decision you've made to enter into service in our armed services of the United States of America. I want to thank our presiding officer, Ms. Greenwood. Thank you very much, Ms. Greenwood. Great job. And Ms. Carter, just wonderful examples of the students we have at Alabama A&M University. Thank our ROTC program. Let's give them a hand, please, our ROTC program. Our wonderful band under the direction of Mr. Carlton Wright, our band. Thank you again, Colonel Heyward, for sharing with us today as we celebrate and recognize Veterans Day. To all of the program participants, we certainly want to thank you for being here. To our community supporters that are here supporting this program, we appreciate your presence. To the staff of Veterans Affairs and Disability Services, to Ms. Williams and Mr. Pearson, thank you for always doing a very great job in coordinating this program that we have. I want to recognize all members of the clergy. Would they please stand? All members of the clergy, would you please stand? Thank you for your presence here. And on a point of personal privilege, I want to recognize specifically Reverend Maurice Wright, who is the new pastor at St. John African Methodist Episcopal Church. Reverend Wright, would you please stand? Happens to be my pastor, so I can take that personal privilege. And welcome to Huntsville, Alabama. To our faculty, all faculty members of Alabama A&M University, if you're here, please stand. Our faculty, staff members, any staff members present, would you please stand and be recognized? Staff members of Alabama A&M. All alumni of Alabama A&M University, would you please stand and be recognized? All alumni of Alabama A&M University. All of our students, would you please stand and be recognized? All of our students. And I'm going to ask that we stand and recognize the veterans of the United States of America. Would you please stand and recognize our veterans? Thank you so very much for the service and what you continue to do and have done for the United States of America. Alabama University will continue to have programs of this sort to express to you our sincere appreciation. Thank you very much.
Next, we will have closing remarks by Ms. Sanoyia L. Williams, Director of Veterans Affairs and Disability Service, followed by the moment of silence, the playing of taps, Mr. Carlton Wright, Director of the University's Band.
Gosh, it was so hard for me to come up with a way to close out the program, and even more difficult now that I'm following our keynote speaker, Colonel Heyward, as well as our president of Alabama A&M University, Dr. Hugini. I chose a poem and actually did some revisions. The poem was written by Joanne Fuchs, and I think that this would be very, very appropriate. When America had an urgent need, you, the brave ones, raised a hand. No hesitation held you back. You were proud to take a stand. You left your friends and family. You gave up normal life to serve our country and our God. You plowed into the strife. You fought for freedom and for peace on strange and foreign shores. Some of you lost new friends while others lost their lives in long and brutal wars. Other veterans answered a call to support the ones who fought. Our country had requirements for the essential skills you brought. We salute each and every one of you, the noble and the brave, the ones still with us here today, and those who rest in their graves. So here's to our country heroes. You are a cut above the rest. Today we give honor that is due to our country's very best, you, our veterans. I would be remiss if I did not share this moment with my colleague, Mr. Quentin Pearson.
Well, we just want to say thank you and for our colleagues for our continued support of our office and our Veterans Aid program. And I would be remiss if I didn't thank Captain Lee for having all of the ROTC cadets out with us today and our own Bulldog vets in our office for all the support they have for us for our program. And if you don't mind, for the cadets, you're already standing, and of our Bulldog vets, if you don't mind, please stand so you can be recognized.
Next, we'll have a moment of silence playing a task by Mr. Carlton Wright, a rector of the university's bands.
Let us pray. On this day of remembrance, we think on the lives that were given for us in this democratic nation, the precious gift of their honor, their duty, and their lives still paving the way for our future. The spirit of our veterans is here, strengthening our resolve to maintain the freedom and democracy they lived and died for. Today we stand together, remembering all that has been paid for our freedom and democracy in the sight of God. We're thankful for the gift, and we're thankful for the giver. Bless us now and even forevermore. Amen.
Proved in myself. Yeah, country loved. Singing something like this. Listen here. Oh, beauty valley, far spacious skies, far amber waves of grain, far purple mountain majesties. Above the fruited plain. But now wait a minute, I'm talking about America, sweet America. You know, God done shed his grace on thee. Yes, he did. Heavy brotherhood from sea to shining sea. You know, I wish I had somebody to help me sing this. Singing something like this. Listen here. Oh, beauty valley, far spacious skies, far amber waves of grain, far purple mountain majesties. Above the fruited plain. But now wait a minute, I'm talking about America, sweet America. You know,